The Lyrids meteor shower is one that occurs over a two-week period in April and usually peaks on April 22nd. The records of this meteor shower go back as far as 687 BC, making it the oldest known record of any meteor shower to date. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and in this video, we will examine the cause of this meteor shower and get practice with identifying the constellation of Lyra, since that is the radiant for this meteor shower. So let's get started. The source of this meteor shower are particles of dust shed by the long period comet known as C-1861G1, also called the Thatcher comet, since A.E. Thatcher discovered it in 1861. It's also worth mentioning that Carl Wilhelm Baker also independently found this comet. And any time a comet comes around the sun, they emit a streak of dust that turns into this dusty trail around their orbit. And each year, the Earth passes through these dusty debris trails. These particles then enter our atmosphere, they burn up and create beautiful, colorful streaks across the sky. Now, I don't have a picture of comet C-1861G1, and that's because its orbital period is 415 years. So the last time we saw it was in 1861, and it's expected to make a return to Earth around 2283. However, I did pull a picture of the comet for you just so you can see that dusty debris trail that I was talking about. This comet is called Neowise, and it visited us a couple years back when this video was formed. So let's take a look at a couple of pictures of meteors and get to know the difference between a meteoroid, a meteor, and a meteorite. So this picture was taken from the International Space Station, and it's so gorgeous because you can see the atmosphere of the Earth right here, and here you can see this streak of light, and that's because a particle of dust is burning up in our atmosphere. And meteors, the definition of it is that they are objects that glow due to the friction while traveling through Earth's atmosphere. So they appear as a streak of light in the sky, and they can often vary in color. And the reason for that is because the difference in composition of the dust particles. Here I've got some action shots of meteors. And when you're observing meteors across the sky, you can't really predict, you know, when you're going to see them. You just have to kind of lay back, get comfortable. If it's cold outside, grab a blanket. I definitely recommend lying down so you don't exhaust your neck by looking up. And it's really a great thing to see. The challenge I often have with seeing meteor showers is often light pollution, either from artificial light or even natural light, such as the moon or naturally the weather systems. I can count on my hand many, many times I've missed meteor showers because it's simply cloudy out or it's raining. And I know that's frustrating, but I can also vividly remember some of the meteor showers I've seen that have been incredible. So you really have to try to seek out dark skies if you are going to watch a meteor shower. Now, here's another picture I've got. We've got the International Space Station, and here is a meteor right here. You can see that thin layer of atmosphere on the Earth. So now we'll take a look at the difference between a meteoroid, a meteor, and a meteorite. So a meteoroid is a small rocky body floating in space, but when it enters our atmosphere and starts to burn up, it's a meteor. When it hits the surface of the Earth, it becomes a meteorite. Whenever I teach this concept to my students in the classroom, I often make them draw the difference between the three, and every time, most students, what they do is they just draw me a rocky body. But I say, you know, that's, you're right, but you have to show me the location. Show me how it's different. So they always end up adding to their drawings, just showing where exactly a meteor, meteoroid, or meteorite is. And meteor showers are named after the place they appear to originate from in the sky. For example, the Geminids meteor shower originate from the constellation Gemini. The Lyrids meteor shower originate or appear to originate from the constellation of Lyra. And when we photograph meteor showers, it appears that if we trace these streaks of light back to the origin point, We call this a radiant. And this is because meteor showers are traveling, the particles are traveling in parallel paths at the same velocity. So they appear to the observer to radiate from a single point. And I've got some pictures to kind of further explain this. So here we have Lyra, the bright star. In Lyra is Vega. And this is where the radiant is located. And remember, we name meteor showers after where the radiant appears to be. Which constellation is it? So this concept is very similar to train tracks. Like if you take this picture of a train track, we know that these train tracks are parallel and they appear to converge at a single point in the horizon, according to the observer. But that's not true. We just know that these railroad tracks, they're parallel. So meteor showers are almost always named after the constellation from which the meteors appear to originate from. This picture that you're seeing here, this is the Perseids, which is a really great meteor shower to observe in like mid-August, I would say is the best time. But this is where the radiant is for that particular meteor shower. And I wanted to share one other photo of a radiant with you. I love this. I love old astronomy drawings from, you know, way back when, before we were taking pictures of stuff. And this is one that I found that I just thought was really cool to share with you. So now what I'd like to do is get some practice with you on how to identify the constellation of Lyra, which is a really easy constellation to point out, mostly because of this bright star Vega. And also the pattern that it makes in the sky is really easy to point out. So this is what Lyra looks like. It's represented as a harp, but to me, it kind of looks like when I look at this shape, it makes me think of a diamond ring. Like here is where the ring is, and this is the diamond sitting on top of the ring, but other people may see something different, and that's okay. Remember, constellations are man-made concepts, and it appears that these stars are connected, even though they aren't in reality. So just notice this parallelogram shape. That's kind of another shape I try to drill into my students is, look at that parallelogram shape with the bright star on top. So if you're struggling to find this particular constellation, you can use the summer triangle as well. The summer triangle is an asterism in which we can connect the three brightest stars that we see in the summer to make a triangle shape. Keep in mind, I do have a whole video about the summer triangle as well as Lyra. So if you want to see those videos, be sure to go check them out. But this is the pattern of the summer triangle. And they connect the three constellations known as Lyra, Cygnus, and Aquila. So Lyra is right down here. Notice the parallelogram shape and the bright star Vega. We have Cygnus right here. It makes this big cross in the sky. And then Aquila is down here. You're only seeing a portion of Aquila. But the stars that it connects are Vega, Deneb, and Altair. Vega is the brightest of the three. So if you can make this pattern in the sky, then you know, okay, Vega is going to be the brighter one, and therefore I can find Lyra. So I wish you luck when trying to find the Lyrids meteor shower. Now that you've watched this video, you know why we see meteor showers, how they're named, and how to identify the constellation of Lyra. Remember, anytime you go out and view the stars, it takes time, patience, and practice, especially patience when it comes to the celestial events, because weather most of the time is the greatest barrier from being able to see these celestial events. So I do hope the weather is on your side and you have cloud-free skies. Also, try to avoid light pollution when you can, whether it's natural, like the moon. Sometimes we can't control that. We can't control when the moon is going to be out, but we can try to escape the artificial light from cities. So thank you so much for watching. And as always, keep looking up.